Good day. It's another day in which to excel, and I'm back with another video. It is Mark from Ford Mustang 98 Guy, and I'm coming back with another update. Now, I can't remember that person's name on one of my videos requested another update on the Buick, my Buick. I forget what your name is, but whoever requested me to do an update on my Buick, here's your requested video. And today is the last day of April, and tomorrow is the first day of May, 2022. So, for the month of April, 2022, I'm gonna do an update on my 2002 Buick Regal Luxury Sport, which is an LS. Well, as you see, I still have the Buick. A lot of people have been asking me about it. So, it's still here. I still drive it every day. It's my daily driver. And it's been my first car that I've had since 2017. So, 4 years I've had this car. It'll be 5 years later in the year that I've had this car. As you can see, the body still looks good for being 20 years old. You know, we're in 2022, and believe it or not, this car is 20 years old. I can't believe it, man. 20 years later, this car still looks good. I always keep this car looking nice. I did take it to the car wash on Friday. I really want to start hand washing it, like washing it by hand, because I prefer doing it that way. It's just doing it like going to a car washes and stuff don't really do a good job. I usually go to a touchless car wash, but anyway, car looks pretty clean for the most part. I'm gonna point out a few things. If you look over here. I'm not sure how that got there. It wasn't for me, unless maybe when I was at work, maybe somebody must have scraped the side. Who knows? I mean, this scratch was here when I bought the car. I mean, there is some bruises here and there. I mean, it's not perfect. The paint still looks pretty good. This is the original paint. But if you look over here at the back bumper, this was repainted. This was repainted, as I showed you in last year in 2021, I had this repainted because up here was all faded from the sun. The sun like baked this. This really, it was faded. This was all painted by a spray can. I talked about that in my last update video. You know, like, the car is not in that bad a shape. I mean, if you look right over here, you can see there's a, I'll point my fingers right there. There is a dent right there. I'm going to get that pulled out eventually. And then on this side, there's a teeny, teeny, tiny dot, like a dent. There's a teeny, tiny dent right around here. I don't know if you can see it, but if I stand back, you can probably see it. It's probably hard to tell. Kind of there. I don't know if you can see it well. It's just a small dent. Other than that, I mean, I don't know if that was there from before. Maybe it was. I'm not sure exactly. But on this side, there is a dent. Like, I noticed that was that's a dent. I don't know if you can tell. It's hard to tell on camera, but I can tell in person that there is a dent on this side. It's not really easy to pick up on the camera, but anyway, moving forward, I had this repainted as well. This was actually repainted just to make it match the color, because this used to be black. Had that repainted. Plus, the fender, a little bit of paint was chipping off. Remember I talked about that last year. The paint was chipping off from under there.
right under there. So I had that blended and polished, whatever, all that taken care of.
Like, for some reason, this car is in really good shape. Now, and I got a different design of the Regal custom-made decal right there. This is a matte finish design. Last September when I made an update video, there was a gloss design, but you know what? This right here looks even better. Even though it doesn't shine, this is a matte finish on the decal there. You can see it right there. So anyway, that's that. But the car still looks good. I mean, like I don't know why I filled that in with touch-up paint, but I'm gonna try and compound, heavy cut compound. Like, I do have some compound, like heavy cut stuff to make the body look better. Little scratches there. You know, it's not a perfect car. I mean, it's I wouldn't say this car is perfect, but still looks like brand new. I mean, whoever had this car before me, they took really good care of it. But now we're going to come to the bottom of this. Here's a story now. So back in the winter, early this year, I was coming home from a friend's house, and all of a sudden, when I take off, my transmission kind of like slam, like it's kind of hard to do it. Like I can't really drive and hold the camera at the same time, but like when I get to second gear, especially from first and second gear, I wouldn't say jerky. It's literally slam, like hard slam. Like there's no engine light on. So then I scanned for a transmission code. I put the scanner in for a transmission code. Apparently I have a P1811 maximum adapt long shift. Now, anybody who has a Buick Regal or a Pontiac Grand Prix with the 3800 V6, please, I just need some help on this, because I feel like the transmission's gonna give out on me one day, and I don't want the transmission to give out. And I've already talked to John, my neighbor, who's a mechanic, about this problem, and he told me I wouldn't worry about it. To me, I think it's a tranny shift solenoid inside the transmission. Now, the transmission itself, I mean, I've had the fluid flushed and, you know, tranny flush, including a service, when I bought the car at 78,000 kilometers, when I first got this car. Like, because I don't know when the fluid was last changed. I don't know if the fluid, when I did a fluid flush at that time, it may be because of that. To be honest with you, I don't think that's gonna hurt it, because the mileage was super, super, super low, 78,000. Right now I have 122,000. It's about to turn 123,000. So anyways, enough of me talking there. Let's do a startup. Sorry about that. I gotta touch that up there with some touch-up paint. That looks like a chip there, or whatever. And I did put new floor mats from WeatherTech. These are custom made. I actually had to cut some edges off just to make it fit. This is from WeatherTech, and it does fit. And also, I talked about this last year as well. The airbag is all stained, especially up top. I'll sit inside and show you what I'm talking about. The leather interior is still in good shape. I did put leather cleaner and conditioner on the seats. I always do that every time. I mean, the seats, it's wear and tear. I mean, you can see right here. There's some cracks on the seat there. The passenger seat's phenomenal. I'll even show you the passenger side real quick. If you look at the passenger seat, just take a look. Take a look at the passenger seat. This side's not bad. It's a little dusty there, but it's still in good shape. Now, if you look at the steering wheel, I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. And the only flaw in the interior is right there on this side of the dash. It's just a small crack. Now, that was there. If you look there, that was there when I bought the car. It was already like that. That was already there when I first bought this car, believe it or not. So, we'll get in the interior, and before I start it up, I'm going to show you what I'm exactly talking about. Okay, so if you look over here, like I talked about, this is all stained. I don't know if a lot of Buicks do this, but if your Buick Regal or Century has this issue with your airbag looking like this, please let me know. I don't know if this is a common problem, but I used some hand wipes. I literally cleaned this one time, and then all of a sudden I put all-purpose cleaner, and then this literally just turned a different color, and then all these stains popped up, and now I feel like those stains are never going to come out, because I put a special type of dressing on there just to bring back the color of the interior, because this is a dark gray, and you can see there's a little bit in there too. But you know what, the thing is, it's a 20-year-old car. I can't make this thing look super perfect. It's not going to look like a new car. And for some reason, when I keep turning the key on, sometimes the CD player, and now it's, see, that's the thing. And here's another thing I wanted to show you guys. When I have the key in the ignition, here's the key. Now when I put the key in, watch what happens. The door chime doesn't ding anymore. Like, before it used to ding, but if you go like this with the key, so if you like hold your finger there on the key, see where my finger is right there, and you let go, the dinger just stops. But if you go like that, it'll work, and then it'll work when it's in that position. For whatever reason, I'm not sure why the door dinger does not work when the key is in the off position anymore. I'm not sure if a lot of these GM cars tend to do that for some reason, for whatever reason. So, anyway. Alright. So, I'll do a startup real quick. But I don't know why the key doesn't ding anymore. Like, here's the ignition. See, now the key's in there. Now it works when it's in the accessory position. It's just kind of weird. Oh, and another thing. I had to get my right front wheel bearing replaced again, because I was driving home one day, or on the way to work, whatever, and the ABS and service vehicle soon and track off light, which is this right here, the ABS and service vehicle soon and traction control light came on, because there is the sensor that's hooked up to the wheel bearing was bad, and apparently I had to get another wheel bearing. But now, as you can see, other than the seatbelt light and the door being open, I'll just close the door just to show you proof. Take a look. No warning lights on the dash, and this car runs like a beauty. But the worst problem is the transmission. I hate to say this, but I don't know why my transmission shifts bad sometimes. Like, when I'm taking off from a stoplight, or if I'm getting on the road, whatever. It's mostly second gear where it slams. if anything seriously happens to this car, listen to my words. I am not going to get rid of this car. Just believe me, I am not going to scrap this car. Look at the mileage right there. It almost has, sorry, the camera's going out of focus again. It almost has 123,000 kilometers. Right now, this is the current mileage I have. 122,984. 122,000 kilometers. That's seriously still a spring chicken. Like, I don't understand what is up with this car. And I don't know why my camera's going out of focus for whatever reason. Because now I'm losing focus. Oh, and plus, I had a, had to get the outer tie rod, left front outer tie rod replaced on the driver's side because there's some play in the driver's side wheel in the front. So, anyway. Like I said, the only transmission was option or available for this car was the 4-speed automatic transmission with overdrive, and then you have low gear selection. So, and then I'm surprised, you know, 20 years later, look at this. This display here still works. Radio. Can't play that because I'm going to get a copyright. Anyway, driver info is over here. And look how much miles per gallon I'm getting. 19.5, which is 20 liters per 100 kilometers. That's your cruise control. Anyway, now I'm gonna show you guys the motor. Roll down the window. Actually, before I pop the hood, I'll show you all the lights work. I'll just show you guys the lights real quick while we're at it. I did put halogen headlights as well in there. See how bright they are. I'll pop the hood in just a sec and I'll show you guys underneath the hood. So yeah, the Buick is doing good still. Fog lights work. Now there is a little bit of stone chips there. There's one right there. That's one there. So I gotta touch up some stone chips as well. It's not perfect. I mean, this car still runs good. I don't know if you guys can see that, but in there,
it's kind of hard to tell. You won't be able to see it. I had a new tie rod replaced on that side, left front outer tie rod. It's gonna be kind of hard to see. I can't get my camera in there, but you can kind of see it in there. New tie rod, outer tie rod.
All the lights work.
The license plate lights work. There's the exhaust.
So
let's open the hood.
Show underneath the hood. Let's see if I can take some pictures after when I'm done this video for my Instagram. Ugh. So under the hood we have a naturally aspirated 3.8 liter V6. This is the Buick 3800 Series 2, which produces 200 horsepower and 225 pound-feet of torque. And I had the air filter, which goes in here, had that changed because I haven't had it changed since 2018. I always keep up on my maintenance on this car. Had to add a touch of coolant to the reservoir. I always do my oil changes, my oil change twice a year. When I put on my summer tires and when I put on my snow tires, that's when I usually do an oil change on this. So I've been driving this car for 4 years and this engine still runs good. I should not be having any major problems with this car. Oh, and during COVID, I even changed the cabin air filter as well. I got to take a look at that again because I didn't. It's already been 2 years now. I'm going to have to take that off one day and see how the cabin filter looks. I'm going to have to take a look at it one day. And believe it or not, it's so easy to do. All you got to do is pop that off a little bit. You undo these two there. There's one and there's another plastic rivet, whatever you want to call it. And then you unscrew this with a flathead, take it off, the filter's right in there. It's so easy to do. Now I gotta change that as well on my grandfather's Buick Century. I don't think the cabin air filter in his Buick has ever been done. So, looking forward to doing that one day. But here's the engine under my Buick here, the 3800. Now this is a Series 2. This is such a fantastic motor. But the sad part is, like I said, is the transmission. The transmissions in these cars are a bag of shit. And sorry, I didn't mean to curse right there, but, and I totally forgot to clean under there, but anyway. The transmissions in these cars are a bag of shit. So, don't you worry. If anything seriously happens, I'll keep you guys updated. But that's that. And I always keep the back seat covered. I put some leather care on the back seat as well. I just covered it up just to protect the leather. But look at this front seats. Front seats still look good. I put Regal floor mats back there. These came out of a 99 Regal. Oh, and I'll open the trunk real quick. One thing did change in the trunk. I'll go ahead and show you. One thing changed in the trunk. One thing. Take a look at this. Check that out. I even organized my trunk too, by the way. I took everything out and I literally vacuumed the whole trunk back here. I got my washer fluid. Oof, my bad, sorry. I'm always organized with my stuff. I got my oil in there because this thing tends to burn oil, so I have to top it up once a month, depending on, you know, if it's low. My gloves, washer fluid on that side. Right here I got more washer fluid. My snow brush is in there. This is for when I top up my washer fluid. I got an umbrella just in case if it rains. always good to have spare stuff. This is for like if I have to, if there's like slush or salt underneath the wheel wells and I can't get them out. But one thing changed in the trunk. Take a look at this. New trunk support. So the trunk arms that hold the trunk support. On this side, if you take a look at this side over here was bad. And one time, it actually hit my mom in the head. The trunk hit my mom in the head one time. This was like a couple years ago this happened. So you know what? I wanted to change the trunk supports. And look at that. If I'm gonna stand back now and take a look. The trunk stays open. Look at that. It doesn't even fall. Well, there you go. That's the trunk for you guys. And then on this side, I had the rocker panel fixed because there was a hole right over here. I always keep this car looking good. I always keep it nice. I try to take good care of it. Like the seats are actually in phenomenal shape, if you can tell. Sit on the other side. Go ahead and show you the passenger side real quick. Oh. That's a glove box right there. This is another common problem too. The latch for the glove box tends to break on these cars too. That's another common issue. Actually, I think my grandfather's Buick had this issue too. His, it opens, but you gotta be a little bit gentle when you close it because the latch on, not this Buick, his Century, the 2000 Buick Century, my grandfather's car, the latch is a little bit off the track. If you guys know what I'm talking about. There you go. There's the driver's side. I like these two. Extra sunshade pull out. You know, one thing I like about this car, it's really good on the highway. Like, take a look, no warning lights on. That's just because I have the door open, but there's no warning lights on. There should be nothing wrong with this car. Like, literally. There should not be anything wrong with this car. So anyway. I showed you, pretty much talked about everything. And the mirror is automatic dimming. Lights work. Cup holders. I changed this out. This was out of another Regal from the junkyard. And I painted that as well. But anyway. There's a storage center console. Cigarette lighter. Ashtray. This car was smoked in before. As you can see, there's a little bit of... The guy who had this car before me did smoke in it. Like, this was already here when I bought the car. I don't smoke. I don't know why people just tend to smoke inside the car. It's just, it stinks up the whole interior after, and then especially gets on the glass and you can't even clean your windows. It's just a pain in the ass. But yeah, anyway, I'm gonna shut this off now. Anyway, that's it. Yeah, I don't know why, when you have the key in the ignition, the door dinger doesn't work. And like, see, the key's in the ignition, and it doesn't even ding. Wow. It's just funny. I'm not sure why it does that, but to tell you something, I mean, I don't know if that's a big deal or not. Who cares? I mean, car still runs good. Oh, and let me just, I gotta roll up the window real quick. All right, there you go. Now we come to the conclusion. I know, sorry this video was 30 minutes long, but anyway, the sun is about to set and I'm about to sign off. So anyways, there you go. There is the update for April 2022. And tomorrow's May 1st. And I promise you guys, I'm gonna try my hardest to get more other car reviews done. So anyway, looking forward to that this coming spring and summer. I just want to have a good 2022, and I keep praying to Father God that 2022 is going to be a better year. Last year, I didn't do a lot of car reviews because of this bullshit happening. But anyway, there's going to be a lot of car videos coming, so not going to promise. I'm going to do the best I can. So anyway, well, there you have it, the update on my Buick Regal for the month of April. So I hope you guys enjoyed the update video. And now, this evening, this is Ford Mustang 98 guy signing off. And before I sign off, I just want to show you guys something. My alarm works, and I never even tried this before, but just watch this. Watch this. You just before I sign off, watch this. My alarm works. I never knew the alarm worked in this car, and I literally tested it, and believe it or not, it actually works. Now, this is Ford Mustang 98 guy signing off. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.